Hi Cancer, this is your forecast for the year 2017, first quarter. This is a general reading for Cancer Sun, Cancer Rising, or Cancer Moon. If you have a different rising or moon sign, you might find watching those videos helpful or more informative for you. Please remember that these are general readings, and so they may not apply to everyone. If you would like a personal reading that is specific to you, please visit my website at thealchemistastrologer.com, provided on the link at the upper corner. If you have visited the site before, you'll need to clear your browser's cache for the schedule button to function properly. So, Cancer, for you, the first quarter, beginning in January, you have the Four of Wands. So this is a great card. It's a very fortunate card. So you're trying to make some progress. You may be in the first stage of some kind of project and you're trying to get it on solid footing. Maybe you're continuing a project, but there is progress being made. And maybe you're getting some good signs that you're on the right track and to keep going. Now, some of you, maybe moving house is impacting your finances. Maybe you're trying to set up a new home, or maybe you're attending something that affects your finances, some kind of gathering with others. For a few of you, maybe you're taking a vacation of some sort. But for the most part, this is about creating some kind of opportunity that's going to give you the chance to set yourself up in a way where you feel more secure. So there's some beneficial changes that could take place that will give you a greater sense of peace of mind. Given how you work it, you could create, you know, situations that benefit both you as well as others, perhaps your family, and set yourself up in a way where you gain some peace of mind. Also, if you have been working on something and you're coming to a point where you want to know exactly where you stand, this is going to be the month where you find out about that. You could find out the truth of where you are in a situation financially, career-wise, with a project, where now you get to take that information and use it in ways that allow you to prevent something from going in the wrong direction, improve it, repair it, or even undo some damage that has occurred in a situation to reinforce your security. Now, one of the issues that could be a problem for you is acting impulsively and making moves without getting, you know, the proper information or following the proper course of action, and just leaping before you look, not thinking also before you speak. You may find it difficult to get along with your coworkers, your colleagues, and you may find fault with their efforts, or they may find fault with yours. So in that case, you're having to rethink some situations that are actually posing a threat to your security. And this could be because you're so self-involved in your own interests that you're not really paying attention to the facts. Now, in a negative, this could be some kind of challenge that's causing a delay on a project, or you're not moving forward in your career the way you had hoped, or Even if you are successful, that success is coming at a greater price for you than you had anticipated. So for some of you, you know, there could actually end up being a job loss or the dissolution of some kind of partnership. You may need to focus on protecting yourself from a loss. But, and this could be by, you know, not providing proper service. If you're in a service industry, there could be some challenges where you end up providing poor service. But generally, this is about, you know, that first stage of success where you're laying the groundwork, the foundation, and there's a sense of excitement about where you are. You're seeking some stability, power, and progress in what you're doing. Now, by the middle of the first quarter, things are really moving quickly. Now, you may be on the go, maybe you're traveling, you're being very aggressive, or maybe you're dealing with people who are being very pushy and assertive. But this is going to be a period where you may need to act quickly. You're trying to overcome some kind of challenge. Now, this could be with regard to communication or traveling. You may get a job offer, or maybe you're doing some traveling for business. But this is all about forward motion, trying to manifest something. And if there were any blockages, this could be the period where those are removed and opportunities are arriving for you quickly. So in that case, you know, whatever it is, you're having to accommodate some kind of change. Now, this could be negative change. There could be some delays or some disruptions to your plans where things are stalled or they're not moving as quickly as you want them to. Now, you could be dealing with some type of contention where there are disputes about what's going on, or you feel as if you're wasting energy, or things are moving so quickly that you feel out of control. Some of you may be involved in situations where someone is being too pushy. They're trying to force an issue, and that's creating, that's becoming problematic. And again, there could be a loss of a job, something is canceled or delayed, some kind of broken proposal, connection, or some kind of miscommunication. But during the middle of this quarter, there's something that happens that's unexpected for you, where you're going to have to change course. No matter how thorough or how detail-oriented you have been, the course of events are not going to flow in the manner that you think. And so you're going to have to step back and remove yourself from a situation to readjust how you're looking at it and make some tweaks. So perhaps whatever is happening, you're having to really act quickly to try to save something or finish up a project or launch something new, because you're having to accommodate a new situation. Now, for others of you, you have been really aggressive in whatever you're doing with regard to your career, and you're getting a lot more done than you had even expected, because during the month of February, you're able to make some really quick and sound decisions. So either one or two things: you are moving and things are taking off, or things are suddenly running away and overwhelming you and running over you. Now, by the end of the first quarter, you have this Five of Wands. So perhaps there was some contention. This is a card about possible conflict. Now, some of you may be, you know, competitors or a challenge or opponents, or there again could be contention within your work environment, a project, maybe you're struggling with your finances. Whatever it is, now you are questioning what's going on. You're looking at, because of something unexpected, you're looking at what you're doing, your work, your course of action, your goals, your objectives, and your work. You're looking at the people that you're connected to as well, and you're questioning, you know, whether this is indeed appropriate. You may decide, given what you find, you're going to take on more. You're going to push farther. And even if there are problems, for some of you, you're going to play your hand. You're going to keep your cards close to your chest. You're not going to take the bait that is presented with regard to people that are difficult. But for some of you, you're absolutely going to be involved in some power struggles, some ego battles, and things are going to be way more difficult than necessary. There could be a lot of criticism and nitpicking and zeroing in on things that make you argumentative. But they're really excuses, because they're really excuses to start conflict, because you're not getting to the root of the real problem. Some of you have some indecision. It's difficult for you to make up your mind about what you want to do and where you're going in this situation. And the end of the quarter, if that's the case, could find you constantly putting out fires. There's one thing after the next, and you end up burning yourself out in situations where you really don't feel as if you're getting ahead. Now, again, this could be involving some underhanded opponents, just a lot of competition, but some of you are just super ambitious and you've got a lot of plans in the work. And you may be having conferences and meetings where you come together with other people in order to work out and solve some problems and create some solutions. The first quarter, all of your cards are fire. And so this is a lot of passion, drive, ambition that can really take you some places, really take off. But it can also be destructive energy where you end up burning yourself out. Now, your advice card is, my what is need not influence my what is becoming. What is has no bearing on what is coming unless you are continually regurgitating the story of what is. By thinking and speaking more of how you really want your life to be, you allow what you are currently living to be the jumping off place for so much more. But if you speak predominantly of what is, then you still jump off, but you jump off into more of the same. So this is all about trying to create some beneficial changes, putting your ambitions in the right place, focusing on, you know, where you are and where you want to be and how you're going to get there. In this present moment, in the first quarter, regardless of what your situation is, this is just a starting point. This isn't the destination. So remember that. Now, with regard to love and romance, this is difficult in a general reading. So if this part of the message resonates with you, great. If it doesn't, this part is not for you. But you have the World card. This is a major card. So in this first part of the quarter, you may be traveling with your partner, or you're separated from your partner because you're traveling. Maybe you are having a long distance relationship, or perhaps you are dealing with somebody who has a different cultural, ethnic, religious, philosophical, social outlook that is different from yours. But this is the end of the tarot deck. So your relationship is reaching some type of peak or culmination where it's now going to enter a new phase. Now, whether that's good or bad, that you would know that. But there's a part of your relationship that has ended in some particular way and is now changing. Some of you may feel as a sense of fulfillment. This is the best possible outcome, and it's culminating and turning into something that's long term. For others of you, you've reached a peak and you're wondering if you're feeling fulfilled, if the relationship is offering you everything that it could. This is also about second chances and forgiveness. And so there may be issues in your relationship, you know, where that's the thread that's running through the relationship. Maybe there's a need for forgiveness for whatever reason. Or maybe there's a second chance. You may be reconnecting with someone. Or maybe somebody is asking for forgiveness and a second chance, you or your partner. But there is unfinished business. And for some of you, you're simply closing yourself off to opportunities or possibilities in connection to relationships. And it could be because you're so focused on making money and career. Now, by the middle of the first quarter, you have this Devil card. So this is a card about limitation and feeling confined and chronic habits or conditioning that keep you in bondage in some way. So you may be thinking negatively about your relationship, or perhaps you're dealing with some codependency issues, or there are fears and insecurities that are controlling the relationship. Maybe there are issues of selfishness. Maybe you're involved in some kind of unhealthy attachment where you feel oppressed and yet you refuse to leave it. Maybe there are issues of abuse or addiction or obsession, whether that's with power, with sex, or with money. Or maybe you're just in a very sexual relationship where that is the focus rather than, a more solid relationship. Some of you, maybe you're tempted by someone or tempted to be with someone else. For many of you, this could be, you know, again, an obsession with either the material or the physical that overrides everything else. But in the middle of the first quarter, you are very determined to get your way in the relationship. So you may be, whatever you're doing in the relationship, you may be trying to talk yourself into the idea that it's right or you deserve to do it this way because this is really what you want. Or maybe you're losing control in the relationship. But there is a strong instinct regardless that is driven by something, whether it's emotional or material. And those instincts are either going to be used constructively or destructively. Now, for some of you, maybe there have been some issues with the relationship, and this could be a month where you actually come up with some ingenious solutions that manage to save the relationship in some way. But others of you, there are issues of pushing too hard, pushing too far, with the possibility of breaking the relationship. Maybe there's some risky behavior taking place, or maybe you're in a relationship and you want to be, you want that other person to desire you and you desire the other person, but you're struggling with your fear about whether you're being used, whether you're being taken advantage of, how much they're going to want from you. Do they expect too much? How much do you have to give? So you may be looking at what is within your limits in the relationship. And, you know, perhaps you're dealing with a no-win situation. Now, by the end of the first quarter, you have this King of Swords. Perhaps you're involved with an air person. This is Gemini, Aquarius, Libra, or maybe this is just the traits of this king. So this is about making decisions more so analytically than emotionally based. And that can be good, or maybe you're closing yourself off emotionally. Maybe you're looking for some kind of way to find some relief, and but maybe you're going about it in a somewhat devious way, or they are. You know, this can be somebody who's not particularly sensitive, and they may find it difficult to relax and allow themselves to enjoy intimacy. And again, maybe this is driven by career or finances. So passion and romance, you know, that may not be a priority. You know, you may follow along and do what is obligatory, but your heart is not in it. There's not a lot of warmth connected to it. Or maybe there's some difficulty even expressing emotion. So this could be somebody who either you or the other person, maybe you're involved in the relationship, but you're not really putting forth anything into it if you don't feel you're getting anything out of it. So maybe somebody's being arrogant or controlling or over analytical. So there could be, for some of you, there's struggles with decision making, and there's a lack of emotional understanding that puts a distance in your love relationship. There could be some deceptions, some, again, controlling or some exploitation. And some of you, there's a lack of libido. There's some cold-heartedness. Now, for some of you, though, this is a king that can allow you to make some decisions in order to handle things in a better way, to create a better situation for yourself. Some of you, the devil represents an obsession, and so you're very determined to win the person that you desire over to yourself. But the problem is you're having difficulty making that first move, stepping out there. You're probably both attracted to one another, but if you don't act, it's possible that this is not going to go anywhere, that the attraction is going to burn out. Now, for some of you, if you are involved in something challenging and intense, then the problem could be there is some miscommunication and both of you are sending out some mixed signals for whatever reason. Now, the theme for this reading is the Nine of Pentacles. So On a professional level, this is about self-reliance, personal achievement. And so it speaks to not really expecting others to come through. They may for you, but it's just as likely that you may be disappointed by other people. So, you know, focusing on persevering and putting your efforts and achieving things on your own is your way of gaining success and solidifying your finances. You could be expecting a lot out of situations or people and maybe even demanding too much. And you're going to realize that that's not going to meet the fantasy of what you have pictured. You're going to have a reality check if you are looking for others to create what you expect. So this is the first quarter is a period for you to really work hard and focus your efforts, and you may be rewarded in some way. This could be the first quarter, a month where, again, you find out that your project is taking off. Maybe you get some kind of a promotion, some kind of recognition. And this is going to be a period where some business connections are going to open up some doors for you in some way. There could be issues that focus on property, self-employment, unearned income, whatever that may be, dividends, pension, retirement, insurance, inheritance, whatever that is, some investment that's going to yield a profit for you. But for others of you, there's going to be struggle surrounding your finances and your career. You may have, again, fierce competition, some underhanded opponents. There could be people that are working against you or behind your back. But for you, the best course of action is to move forward and not pay any attention to that, because that could actually be a problem for you. In that case, again, there may be a false sense of security, and you will really need to protect yourself against any financial loss or any threats to your reputation. Now, romantically, this is saying that you could be someone who is really focused on being alone. You enjoy your own company. And again, there could be issues between you and your partner where the expectation is too great. There are too many demands that don't have the possibility of being met. And so, whatever you're facing, this is like moving forward, getting on with things, going past whatever uncertainty, procrastination, or whatever fears there are of rejection. So you will have to decide whether you are more happy by yourself or whether you're better off paired up with someone else. Now, there could be issues where, again, you're obsessed with someone or attracted to someone or vice versa, and you feel as if that person is out of reach. And maybe, again, that's because no one is acting or there's some mixed signals going on. Or maybe somebody, you know, who is attracted to the other person, they're actually using what they feel is a sense of rejection by trying to pull the other person down rather than build them up. They're chipping away at the other person's confidence. This could be a period where you and your partner decide you just need more space for one another. You need to focus on your own interests. You may be focused more on work during this first quarter or some project rather than the relationship. Now, if your relationship is on solid footing, then great, you'll do fine. If not, this could be a problem. Now, I forgot to mention that for the relationship, you have this pay attention to the red flags. The signs are cautioning you. So there is something about the relationship that is an issue. Now, if this is a new relationship where you feel very passionate, there's a lot of sexual chemistry, you may be getting caught up in that. But this is warning you that you need to pay attention to your feelings and the first impressions that you have of this potential partner, and not allow your emotions to override what you know on a gut level is telling you that's not going to work for you in the long term. Pay attention to not only how they're treating you, but how they treat the people around them. So now, if you're in a relationship, these red flags are telling you that there could be some issues between you of dishonesty, disrespect. There could be issues of substance abuse or a lack of integrity or too much flirtatiousness. And you will have to decide whether you have reached breaking point or if this is a point for you to begin to heal. If there are issues where you want to address, give them a second chance and have forgiveness. So you could be healing your relationship in some way. Now, it's interesting that this pay attention to the red flags also in some way ties into the theme of a message in a bottle. Because this card is telling you that watch out for the signals. Once again, pay attention, because whatever there are clues being put in front of you that are pointing the way to your highest good. So when you open yourself to receive these messages, you can get, you know, confirmation about whether you're on the right path or you're headed in the wrong direction. Now, the message in the bottle says that positively, you're going to get some good news. And so whatever happens, something is coming your way, a phone call, a letter, an email, some kind of information that's going to make you feel good. And you could also be getting some confirmation that you're on the right track, that you're following your purpose, your passion, the direction that your career is headed in, and you are aligned with your destiny. So again, you could be getting a call, some new opportunity, or you may connect with an old friend or business contact that could open some doors for you. But I also feel, given this red flags, that you are getting a message that you need to not acknowledge any signs that cross your path that are red flags, that these are warnings for a reason, that if something doesn't feel good to you instinctually, whether that's with business or in your romantic personal affairs, that is allowing you to make a decision to move in another direction, that the universe has your best interest at heart and it's drawing your attention to something that you're not paying attention to. Now, the underlying energy is this Two of Pentacles. So this is going to be a period of weighing your options, juggling things. Maybe you're juggling, you know, business versus personal, or you just have a lot of responsibilities, demands, obligations that you are, you know, you've got a lot of balls in the air right now. Whatever it is, this is going to be a period where you're going to have some romantic and some financial opportunities that come along with some unexpected good luck, just when you least likely expect it to turn up. And this could be a period where it's very easy because you're so motivated to juggle what's on your agenda. So you may be stepping back to review, restructure some things, make some changes, refocus in order to create some beneficial changes that will give you some benefits in the long term. For others of you, you're looking at your finances and you're trying to, you may have to restructure the budget or revise in some way. You may have to take from one area of the budget in order to pay some bills in another area. Some of you are involved in commerce. You're offering some goods and services, and there's a turnaround, a cycle all the time. But this is a period during the first quarter where you need to be very practical in your approach, because any kind of unrealistic thinking could put you on some kind of emotional or financial seesaw. As a couple, there may be some stress in your relationship, and you may need to make some adjustments and some changes in order to move your relationship forward. You may be so focused on succeeding in the material sense that you ignore the relationship, or you may be focused on building a material foundation together. Some of you, you know, you feel confined in a situation and you are struggling to break out of a rut and a routine. So you need to find ways to support one another. There could be a lot of changes during this period, or again, you're stuck in a rut and you need to address some issues that need to be healed. One or both of you could be too focused on work to be intimate, or maybe you're choosing between two lovers, or whether you should stay in a relationship or end it. And there could be indecision or anxiety about these decisions because of trust issues, past wounds, or relationship problems. Now, some of you, this comes down to whether you should get involved, yes or no, getting involved physically with another person. All right, Cancer, I hope you enjoyed this reading, and I would greatly appreciate your subscriptions, your likes, and kind comments. For those of you who've already offered your support, please know that I am grateful and committed to you. Have a wonderful 2017, and make it count.